Electric cars and plug-in hybrids are all the rage at the moment. But the Toyota Prius, the grandfather of them all, has been out on the road for around 20 years now. The Japanese carmaker has regularly updated the technology, of course. The current model being sold in showrooms is the vehicle's fourth generation. Car tester Ines Petri explains that the latest Prius comes in a full hybrid or plug-in version. The latter is more for people who can run a cable to the car at home. In the full hybrid, on the other hand, batteries are charged by the gasoline engine out on the road or by recovering energy during braking and engine braking, she says. Ines is taking out the full hybrid, self-charging variant of the Prius. Its power is provided by a 1.8-liter gasoline engine and an electric motor that can also work independently of its internal combustion counterpart. A secondary electric motor converts power from the gas engine into electrical energy stored in the batteries. Altogether, the system puts out 90 kilowatts of power. The Prius can hit 100 kilometers an hour from a standstill in 10.6 seconds and has a top speed of 180. Toyota says it burns just 3.3 liters of fuel per 100 kilometers. Ines says that over the years, Toyota has managed to make the hybrid feel more and more like a standard internal combustion engine car. Drivers can choose different driving modes, among them environmentally friendly eco mode, a normal mode, and a power mode for when you want a little more juice. The latter really gives the car a lot of zip. There's also a purely electric mode for when the car is traveling at low speeds. However, the full hybrid only manages that trick for around 2 kilometers. And that's the decisive difference between it and the plug-in version. The plug-in has larger batteries that give it a range in electric mode of about 50 kilometers. This variant is also 11 centimeters longer. But because the technology takes up more space, Prius plug-ins have 140 liters less volume in the trunk. A two-part hatch has also been a character trait in the model for the last two generations. The interior is a study in contrasts and anything but boring. The dashboard display is narrow and sleek. A lot of the important data appears on a high-tech central console. The shifter also has a futuristic look and feel. All these polished surfaces contribute to the car's modern look, says Ines, but they can also start to look dusty pretty quickly. That's why she would recommend always carrying a feather duster on board. Just a swipe and everything gleams again. The displays also make a very modern impression, especially the one up here on the dashboard, which lets you know what's going on in the car all the time. Another modern touch, an induction plate for charging your smartphone without having to plug it in. The most antiquated feature is the parking brake in the footwell. Ines says electric and plug-in hybrid cars are really taking off. But for her, a full hybrid vehicle like this one still has a place, even though its range is much more restricted than a plug-in. That's because not everyone has access to charging cables at home, or just doesn't want the bother with cables all the time. In general, she thinks a key moment for the sector will come when the batteries can be charged through induction, and you can dispense with cables altogether.